Welcome to the advanced selfie challenge of mobile phone photography. I gotta say, I was quite nervous to see if I was capable of taking good photographs on a mobile phone because I'm always relying on my DSLR, and I know a lot of you have been probably questioning as well, like, well, she's good, but what about mobile phone girl? So I decided to take up the challenge and see how I did. In this video, I'm gonna be showing you how I use a tripod, don't use a tripod, and just make do with whatever I have. Indoor locations, outdoor locations, sad locations, happy locations, and if you want to know further how I take my advanced selfies, including how to use a mobile phone settings properly, as well as editing in mobile apps to get the most out of your photographs, I recently released the Sorella Moore Advanced Selfie University. And in there, I cover all of these components. Everything I know about advanced selfies is in there. And I just wanted to give you guys the power to be able to take great photos of yourself, because we all know that photography and photos of yourself these days are absolutely essential. So check out the link in the bio if you would like to find out more about the course. So without further ado, welcome to How to Shoot Mobile Photography 101. All right, so without a tripod, first thing I found is that I can prop it up on here to get a beautiful background. Let me start filming what I'm looking at so you guys can get an understanding. So it's perfect. I can use this setup here and it's pointing to the window. I mean, it's not the perfect setup, but I'm doing whatever I can with what I've been given. So without a tripod, I can set it up. And then I put my settings in place. All right, let's do this thing. Now I've just taken this test shot with the camera facing me. Looks pretty all right. It's okay. I wish I had a tripod so bad. Okay, so now I'm gonna turn the camera around and do the exact same thing with the better quality camera. Not bad, not bad. I don't hate it. So I found another spot for me to shove my camera in and take it from the fence side with the side of the building. So let's take a few more photos here. Yay, I love that one. So that was super basic. That was like the most basic photo you can take with very minimal tools. Now I wanna step it up and make it much more artistic. It's gonna be a beautiful portrait that I see of myself in front of these leaves. So I'm gonna focus on that. I'm gonna be using my tripod as my tripod for this. In this instance, I don't wanna focus on the fact that I don't have a tripod, because if you wanted to do or recreate something like this, you either have a tripod, you make it out of sticks, or you have a stack of books and a chair. Like, there is a way to make it happen. It's just painful for me to be able to teach you how to get the best out of photos. I'm just gonna focus on pretending like this is a good tripod. So that's what I'm doing. So let me get straight into it. So I'm just setting it myself up, the settings. It's nice. I think it might have to be lower. The tripod is gonna, you guys are coming on the ride with me right now. Boom. Oh, that's gonna look good. Do I go shirtless? Sorry guys. So right now I'm just experimenting with the camera facing me to see what looks good. Do I want to go there? No, I think I want something, but not this top isn't right. So BRB. And boom, this is the image that I ended up using. And after editing, this is what it ended up looking. So it's looking pretty good, not gonna lie. Can't wait to show you guys how to edit these photos as well. Just wanted to show the behind the scenes of how I shot this one with this tripod. I was standing here, the camera was set up like this, which was showing you the behind the scenes of what I was doing, how I was posing and so forth. And I just put my camera literally here and here. It was resting on here.
Welcome to the next location. We are shooting indoors now and I'm going to be doing a lingerie shot because there is a bed here and I'm going to be utilizing it. So here we go. Because I'm utilizing whatever I have, I literally was just having my drink and I was like, well, the firehouse is a great height for a standing shot. And I was like, okay, let's point it that way and see what happens. And then I put the glass behind it as a support. Now I'm going to be standing in this location. Let's see what I come up with.
So right now you guys are right next to my phone. My phone is right next to you and I'm trying different poses out. So either sitting here, it's kind of just whatever. Standing against this was a bit like you know, like provocative. I was like, what else could I possibly do? And I just kind of stood here, maybe something like this, like a delicate little pose that tells more of a story instead of the usual, look at my bum, look at me sitting, you know? I wanted something else. I always like to make my poses slightly different to the norm. Maybe something like this. What do you think? Let's get the photo done. So in the end, after testing front camera and seeing what looks good from the poses, it turns out that a sitting pose is my favorite because the rest didn't make sense.
I think mobile photography might be my new addiction because I just went wild and took another photo right here. This is the result and this is post editing.
Okay, so I figured that maybe I'm using the sad photos as a crush to my photograph, so now I'm gonna try a direct sunlight and a happy photo. Two very challenging things. Well, happy is not really that challenging, but the direct sunlight is gonna be very hard with mobile photography. Wish me luck. Firstly, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna walk around with my phone on photography mode so I can see what would look good, which area would look good, like set up the frame before I put myself into it. That's the most basic step one of photography. Okay. That's cute. I already like it. Okay, found the frame. Hot, it's very hot. I can't see myself, just as a reminder. That pose is gonna be horrific. One more, because my face wasn't facing towards the sun as much, because it's gonna be harsh shadows. All right, now to see how I did with the photos. Let's see. Hello there, lovers. Another location, another photo shoot with my camera on top there. It's so ridiculously hot. Let's check out what we got. That's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I had so much fun taking photos with my mobile phone. I didn't realize that you could just transfer your skills from using a DSLR and put it into mobile phone photography. such a silly billy sometimes, but the biggest problems that I found with mobile phone photography, not having a tripod really kind of sucks, but it also just shows me that you can do it. You are able to make everything work with your mobile phone. It's pretty straightforward. And lastly, if you wanted to know more about how I use the settings on my phone, how I edit my photos post taking the photos to get the most out of it, because I honestly think that taking a great photograph is 60% of the work, and then to add your artistic flair and make it your own style and bring the best out of a photograph, it is editing 40% of the photograph. In that case, please check out my Advanced Selfie University that I have just launched. I'm very excited for that university. If you have any questions at all about how I take my advanced selfies, everything is answered in there, like lighting, posing. And if you want to know more about how to pose yourself, face, body, how to pose your hands, lying down poses, standing up poses, group photo poses, as well as how to focus your camera, what to wear, how to choose the right branding for yourself so you get the right message out in the world about you, whether you want to be an artist, a business person, etc., etc., this is on the screen, everything that I'm going to teach you in there. Link is in the bio. It is very exciting for Sorelia to have done this. Let's spread the advanced selfie far and wide so you can take control of your own photographs and your own image in the world. And on that note, here's my Instagram if you'd like to see my photographs. And from me and the sunflower, we would like to say have a fabulous day. And until next time, peace.